try to reduce it back to a light backup that still couldn't turn it up on, instead you were, anytime you went back to telling the backup to jump in at a 5. So, you know, if there's anything you had to do with that. But at the end, that was great, right? Because you only jumped in at a 5 that one time there in this last session. So, and the body language, I'm just going to borrow a little kind of borrow. So, you're telling him back, turn it up, right? Now you need to go ahead, and I would only use about this much. I wouldn't use this much, because what's happening is you're kind of throwing a lot at him. You know, you're not going to be able to be accurate, so I'd only use about this much. Now your body language is already in the get back. Now you can go, right? You want him to really feel you come stepping in, like I'm going to get you. So that way he doesn't, before long, the getting him part wouldn't be necessary because he's going to respond to the floor. He's going to recognize your shoulders dropping. Because as soon as your shoulders drop into that, like almost football wrestling thing, you know, and then the first couple times you do the snap, so he realizes that that's what's going to happen first, and then that comes next. And then make sure that you stay very tuned into the first time you drop your shoulders through those. Because then you want to say, okay, let me give you the benefit of the doubt. Back up without me having to snap. I warned you, and you started the back up. Now, if you warned him and you didn't, now you can call it through. But give him that split second, almost like a microsecond, of I dropped in here, oh, you didn't, I'm going to snap. Okay. Right. So that's going to be a body language that you have to practice.
All right.
And I would almost
practice the whole.
I was going to say, I'd almost practice with something inanimate.
Yeah.
You know, just so that you can kind of even, and we need to hurt to do it in front of a mirror. You know, so you can see what the expression you want him, you know.
Right.
You want him to kind of get that feel like you went from to, you know, when you feel your nose curl, you know. Then, and you hope your shoulders will drop. Then he'll take, the first time you might have to snap him, but the second time you're going to see him go. Right? Because you don't want to have to, like, we're going to hope to always make this just, like, the umbilical cord that's going to eventually get cut.
One thing is, I'm proud that you didn't quit, because there were a couple times you wanted to just quit.
I